happy to be here tonight with you to celebrate this Mass with our pastor here, Father Merrick, Father Tony from Libo, Father Louis, who's from Callahan, who's come quite a way to be with us. And I've looked forward to this Mass all day, looking forward to this celebration, this place, the Santa Fe mission of Our Lady of the Leche. As pastor of Holy Faith, that is what our church is named after, the Santa Fe mission that is in this general area. That was 400 years ago. But we are all inherited the faith of the Spanish Franciscans who came in this area. And how privileged you are that the bishop chose this parish for the special shrine of Our Lady of the Leche on this side of the diocese. It is a wonderful gift to all of us, and my parish and many others come here for pilgrimage and for refreshment. As we come here today, we remember Mary as an intercessor with Christ for us. Let us then ask for her intercession as we confess our sins. I confess.
Mercy on us. Forgive us our sins. Let us pray. As we venerate the glorious memory of the Most Holy Virgin Mary as Our Lady of the Leche, grant we pray, O Lord, through her intercession, that we may too merit to receive from the fullness of Your grace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, Your Son, who lives and reigns with You in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Thank you. This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight.
Part of this epiphany, part of this proclamation of
good news that the Savior has come, and he has been born, Son of God, made flesh in the womb of the Virgin Mary. The image of the Madonna and child is the first icon, the first image of Jesus. And in this evening, we celebrate the image of Mary, of course, as Our Lady of La Leche, the mother of milk, meaning the nursing mother. And we see many portraits of Jesus all the time. Mary holding Jesus in her arms, that Madonna we're very familiar with. There's another one, an icon called Mother of Tenderness from the Eastern tradition, where, and I like that one very much too, as Jesus, the infant, has got his little face pressed on the face of Mary, a very tender image. But Our Lady of Leche goes even further in tenderness and intimacy by showing Jesus nursing at Mary's breast. And it shows his whole humanity, his dependence on Mary. When Jesus, as the Son of God, becomes flesh and becomes Jesus, he doesn't bypass the normal human development that all of us have to go through. He has to eat. He has to be nourished, as all of us do. This is just the beginning of where he shares everything of our humanity except sin. Because really, sin is inhuman. And he's getting his life, his first life from Mary, isn't he? And he is going to become the life, the way, the truth, and the life. I was inspired today by the symbolism of the first statue of Our Lady of La Leche that was placed in the shrine of St. Augustine in the early 1600s. And there's a replica of it now. It was taken away when the British took over Florida, and that would have been, I guess, in the 18th century. And they took the little statue back to Spain. But another one, a replica, was made. And then, of course, you have a replica of the same statue, a very beautiful replica here, at the Santa Fe Shrine of St. Madeline's. And that early shrine was made in the 1600s. It's the first Marian shrine in what is now the United States. And I would dare say you probably have the most recent shrine in the 21st century. The first Spanish settlement of St. Augustine was in 1565. And in those days, Spanish noble women did not breastfeed. What they did is they would turn the infant over to a wet nurse, a woman who had had her own child and now was feeding the noble baby. It was just not done by noble women. I guess it was looked at as too earthy. But this image of our Lady of La Leche is not, she has not turned her baby over to a wet nurse. And even though she is the Queen of Heaven, we see the crown upon her head. This feeding of Jesus, this breastfeeding in that particular time, would have spoken to the people of her humility, that she was not acting like a noble woman, you know, but she was acting like every common woman would feed their child, because she is identifying with all mothers. And I loved as I was reading today, because I didn't, maybe I had read it before, but I was picking up again on the symbolism of this. It was fascinating to me. One of the things which may be denoting her poverty is that she's barefoot. Most women would, you know, noble women would appear in shoes, right? But she's barefooted. And then I got curious And I said, well, I wonder what other images of Mary, if she's barefoot or not. And I'd say that probably in about, I guess, 90% of the cases, she is barefoot. It's an interesting detail. I couldn't find anything that, you know, talked about that per se. There are some images of her where she has on sandals or shoes, but she's barefoot. So that could very much be talking about her humility. And especially, it might be that it is hearkening to the epiphany that was given to Moses on the mountain, where he saw the burning bush. You remember that? And God says, take your shoes off. This place is holy. There's even a song about that. We're standing on holy ground. Interesting, her foot is on a pillow, and I could find nothing about that. I don't know why her foot is on a pillow. Though it may be a sign that of her royalty, as well as her humility of being barefoot. But Jesus is in this cream garment, the infant Jesus. It's in a cream garment, kind of a cream-colored blanket, which in the Spanish symbolism of that day would have denoted wool. He has on wool, and he is the Lamb of God. And Mary has, her underskirt is red, which is the color of sacrifice. But she has on a starry blue mantle, which speaks of the heavens, which speaks of divinity, where she is overshadowed by the Holy Spirit and sees Jesus. She is blanketed by the Holy Spirit. Anyway, as we look at the Virgin Mary, who is the mother of Jesus, she is also our spiritual mother, because the scriptures tell us that Jesus is the firstborn of many brothers and sisters, spiritual brothers and sisters. That's us, the spiritual brothers and sisters of Jesus. And that means that his mother is our mother. She is our spiritual mother. And the early church fathers, and also as recently as the Second Vatican Council, has talked about Mary as a symbol of the church. We used to hear more about the church as Holy Mother Church. Those of you who are a little bit older, remember that? That's usually how the church was referred to, Holy Mother Church. And there is a deep awareness among the early church and what the Vatican Council is trying to recapture of the church as our spiritual mother. She's our spiritual mother because she gives birth to us through baptism. And the nursing Madonna reminds us that the church also nourishes us, the children of God, nourishes us with the Word of God and with the sacraments. St. Peter, the first letter of Peter, says this: like newborn infants, long for pure spiritual milk, so that through it you may grow into salvation. For you have tasted that the Lord is good. And St. Paul describes the church's ministry, his ministry, in this way: we were gentle among you, as a nursing mother cares for her children. Oh, how different it would be if all priests were gentle and cared for those entrusted to them like a nursing mother. Mother who would not harm any child. And I believe in this day that we're living in, we need to recover a sense of the church as our mother, because she's getting beat up, isn't she, in the scandals, which were not the fault of the church itself, but of unworthy priests and bishops, some ignored in the past. And despite the scandals, the church, Holy Mother Church, is still holy, because among our membership, among our communion, is Mary, the sinless Virgin Mary, and the saints, and the faithful, like you and me, who are trying to get through this pilgrimage of life, loyal and holy before the Lord with his help of the Holy Spirit. There are Judases in the church today and in the past. Please do not be surprised by that, because there was a Judas among the 12 apostles. But we don't follow Judas. We follow Mary and her son Jesus Christ into his church, who is our mother. Mary is also called the mother of the church. And we would do well to listen carefully to this gospel today, where the epiphany is of not just Jesus, but Jesus and his mother. And that the Magi, the wise ones, went back to their country by another way. They went back with another way of life, the life of Jesus Christ, who is our holiness, our mercy, our compassion, our nourishment, our strength. And we will follow him with the intercession of Mary.
Let God grant the leaders of his church wisdom to explain and defend the gospel of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That Mary's compassion help others to work together for the peace and common good of all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That members of the church be strengthened by Mary's example as they seek to welcome the Lord into their hearts and homes. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who are sick or hospitalized, especially Anna Marie Martin and Liz Kennedy, that they will feel the embrace of the Blessed Mother in their time of need, and for all caregivers of the ill, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who are suffering the devastating effects of Hurricane Michael, for peace and consolation as they recover, and for all first responders that come to their aid, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
may they come into the light of God's presence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
All the parishioners of St. Magdalene for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for our own personal intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Heavenly Father, hear the prayers of the faithful people, and give us the gift of faith that we may serve one another as Mary served her son. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our offertory song is Dios te salve Maria. It's in the group program. Dios te salve Maria.
Thank you.
Now pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God and Father. We offer you the sacrifice of praise, Lord, as we rejoice in commemorating the mother of your Son. Grant, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we may advance toward eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Give them up to our
Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere.
Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on the feast day of the Virgin Mother of God, Mary, Our Lady of the Leche. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived her only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth the eternal life, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we adore.
And all of the clergy.
from every people. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now
and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And
with
your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Renewed by this heavenly food, we humbly implore you, Lord, and having received your Son born of the tender virgin under the sacrament of signs, we may profess him in words and hold fast to him in deeds. He lives and reigns forever.
I promise I will be very brief, but it is my obligation to say thank you to everybody who in any way prepared or participated in this our celebration of the feast day of Our Lady of Leche. Of course I can talk and talk about everybody, but I am kind of amazed how smooth everything went, but also I am amazed how much work it cost to prepare everything to have this celebration so smooth. Thank you everybody, and I won't name anybody, but thank you everybody who spend hours and hours first preparing and next executing everything what we had during this day. In many cases, it took weeks or even months of preparation. Thank you so much for your participation. Thank you for the participation of all the parishes who came throughout the day to be with us, to pray to God, to Our Lady of Leche. Thank you everybody who are here now. And at the end, I would like to ask you to go after this celebration to our hall. This is obligatory, to go there and to have small refreshment. I think that it will be not small, it will be big refreshment. Please save us from all this food. I hope to see you there again. Thank you so much.
Nuestra Señora de la Leche. It's the same melody as the entrance, but it's in Spanish.